Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'm going to explain you BOOTP protocol. BOOTP means bootstrap protocol. And to understand this protocol, let me tell you how many things that I'm going to cover in this video. So first, I'll explain you how many basics are there with this protocol. After that, I'll explain you how this protocol functions. So working of this protocol is having two segments. One is the regarding same subnetwork. And second is the regarding other subnetwork. So I'll explain you that in great details. After that, I'll explain you how many limitations are there with this protocol. And because of those limitations, nowadays we are not using this protocol widely in computer network. But to understand next protocol, that is DHCP, you will have to learn how this protocol is functioning. So let us see first how many basics are there with this protocol. See, BOOTP is bootstrap protocol, right? It works similar to RARP protocol. In my last video, I have explained how RARP protocol functions, right? You can observe that. So working of bootstrap protocol, that is similar to RARP protocol. Here, there are a few additional functionalities that is there with BOOTP protocol compared to RARP protocol. See, BOOTP protocol that is used to assign IP addresses automatically to network devices using MAC address. In RARP protocol, I have explained how we can assign IP addresses based on MAC address, right? So same thing that we will be doing with BOOTP protocol, right? We will be assigning IP address to device based on its MAC address. See, this protocol functions at transport layer. When we talk about RARP protocol, then you should know it is functioning at network layer, right? While this BOOTP protocol that functions at transport layer. It works based on client-server model. So you should know what is client-server model, right? In client-server model, there will be one server. There will be one server. And that server will be serving multiple clients. Like as if I say, here we are having client 1, here we are having client 2, client 3, client 4. So this server will serve these clients, right? So that is how this protocol is functioning. BOOTP supports relay agents. I'll explain you in working how it supports relay agent. And BOOTP is less commonly used due to static table for IP assignment. So I'll explain you how static table of IP assignment is there, as well as how working is there. And in working, I'll explain you how relay agent functions in BOOTP protocol. So let us see how working is there with BOOTP protocol. So in working of BOOTP protocol, I'll explain you two parts. You can observe here, we are having one subnetwork 1 and here we are having subnetwork 2, right? In subnetwork 1, we are having BOOTP server and here some host are there. So let me explain you first part of working, in which let us say here we are having node A and node A wants IP address. Right now, this node A that is newly added in this network and this node A wants IP address. And as if node A is having IP address, then that node A can communicate in entire computer network, right? So how IP assignments happens, let us try to understand that. So see, this node A is not having IP, right? So what this node A will do is, node A will broadcast one frame. Right, so that will be request frame. So here, if I say this frame that is forwarded by node A, that is BOOTP request, right? That is BOOTP request. Then this request that is getting broadcasted over here in entire subnetwork 1. Now other host that will discard this request. But here in this network, we are having BOOTP server. So BOOTP server will receive this request. This request is the regarding IP assignment for node A. So now what BOOTP server will do is, BOOTP server will give reply in which it will assign IP address to A. See, BOOTP server will be having table. It will be having memory in which there will be table. In table, there will be MAC address and IP addresses, right? So whatever devices that is there in this network which is having MAC address, and along with that it will be assigning IPs. Now right now node A that is newly added in this subnetwork. So here what boot P server will do is it will add MAC address of A and it will assign IP A to this by giving reply. So here it will be forwarding one frame that will be unicast frame. You can say this is boot P reply. And this will go to node A only, that is unicast data, right? It will go to node A only. So now node A will be having IP address, and based on that IP address, node A can communicate in entire computer network. See, this is how basic working is there. But as I have told you, see, boot P supports relay agent. Now, how it supports relay agent? Let us try to understand that. You see, here we are having so many networks, right? We are having two right now, but you can have multiple subnetworks in computer network, right? So here with this subnetwork, we are having relay agent. Now, how relay agent functions? Let us try to understand that. See, here in this network, we are having multiple hosts, like host 1, host 2. Now, let us say host 2 is newly added host and host 2 wants IP address. So, host 2 will do what? Host 2 will broadcast frame over here. That is boot P request that you can say. Right. Now, that will go to all the host which is there in this subnetwork 2. It will not go over here. Why? The reason is host 2 is having only MAC address, and with the use of MAC address, it cannot forward data to other networks, right? To forward data to other networks, host 2 should be having IP address. Now, you see, this relay agent will receive this request, but this relay agent cannot give IP address. Remember this. This relay agent is functioning as agent only. So here, relay agent will receive this request. Now, once this request is received by relay agent, what relay agent does is, relay agent will forward request of H2 to boot P server. So relay agent will be having IP and MAC address of boot P server. So relay agent will give unicast frame. You see, relay agent will give unicast frame. Let me take some other color. Relay agent will forward frame which is unicast frame, and that unicast frame that will go to boot P server, right? So now boot P server will be having idea about in subnetwork 2, host 2 wants to have IP address. So similarly here, what boot P server will do? Boot P server will add this MAC address of host 2 in its entry. Like as if I say here host 2, that boot P server is adding, and IP H2 that it will assign, and it will give reply, and it will give reply to relay agent, right? So in this reply there will be one frame, and that frame will be having IP of host 2. Now once that frame reaches to relay agent, relay agent will forward unicast frame. Relay agent will forward unicast frame to host 2, right? So here you see how it will happen. Relay agent will forward unicast frame to H2. And once that unicast frame reaches to H2, that frame will be having IP of H2. In this frame also, there will be IP of H2 that is received by relay agent. Now this relay agent will forward this IP of H2 to H2. Now H2 will be having IP address. So here one thing that you can notice. See, previously with RARP protocol, with single network, we need to have RARP server, right? But here with boot P protocol, you don't need to have boot P server everywhere, right? With every subnetwork. So here we are having relay agent concept. That's why you don't need to have multiple boot P server. Now, if you think practically, like in computer network, there are so many subnetworks. Do you think like with all the subnetwork you can provide BOOTP server? No. So here there is a concept of relay agent. So every subnetwork that will be having relay agent, and in that subnetwork, if any device is asking for IP address, then relay agent will forward that request to BOOTP server, and BOOTP server will assign IP with respect to MAC address, and it will give it to relay agent, and relay agent will deliver that IP to given host, right? So here we are reducing some complexity. Like if you see RIRP protocol, so in RIRP protocol we have been having multiple RIRP servers with all the subnetworks, right? While with BOOTP you don't need to have multiple BOOTP server. With the concept of relay agent, we can reduce number of BOOTP servers, right? But here one thing that is noticeable, see, this BOOTP server will assign IP address with respect to MAC address, and this is a static table. So once H2 is requesting for IP, so IP is assigned over here. Once A is requesting for IP, then IP of A that is already assigned, right? So because of static table, here fixed IPs that will be assigned to all the host, right? Now those IPs cannot be changed over here, right? And because of that, there are some limitations. Like if you observe how many limitations are there, then you see BOOTP server uses static table for IP assignment. So even if user is not using the network, then also IPs are occupied by the host, which leads to shortage of IPs in computer network. Like if you talk about IPv4, then in IPv4 we can have at max how many IPs? 2 to the power 32 number of IPs. That is somewhere around 4 billion, right? But nowadays with this global population, if you talk about how many population is there, then that is there beyond 7 billion, right? And in total 4 billion IPs that is available. So even if you talk about me, I'm using 10 devices which is having a requirement of IP address, right? So likewise with 7 billion population, how many IPs are required if you have static table? So that's why this protocol is not widely used in computer network, right? And second limitation is what? Instead of RIRP, you should write BOOTP over here. See, with BOOTP protocol, we are having dedicated BOOTP server, and as if this BOOTP server is getting failed, then entire system will get failed, right? So that is how single point failure is also there with this BOOTP protocol. So these are the things which I want to convey regarding BOOTP protocol. In next video, I'll explain you how DHCP protocol is there. That is quite interesting. That is having based on these protocols only. That's why you need to learn this. Otherwise, BOOTP protocol that is not used nowadays. BOOTP protocol was used way back in 1990s, right? It was initiated in 1985, and in 1990s people were using it. Nowadays this is not in used. It is not available in practice, but still you need to understand concepts. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.